tomorrow night. Art Acevedo, what a piece of work. By the way, Art, we've been calling you to get you on for a while, so don't say that we're scared to have you on. Your office must not be letting you know we called. So you're welcome here next week. In fact, in here at this table, Art. But that's a side issue. We got a bunch of clips from this, and we couldn't go there today when Jacques Cousteau's son was speaking because we had to be at the Occupy Austin event. But we were going to ask Jacques Cousteau about his dad saying, it's horrible to say 375,000 people have to be killed a day for the environment, but it's even more awful to say we shouldn't kill 300,000+ people a day. And those quotes are public, along with Prince Philip and others. But I sent the guys down there, and they got their little pass. And then as soon as the other operators of it saw the InfoWars credentials, they started freaking out on them. And they had, the clip's coming up later, Mark... how do you pronounce this guy's name? Yeah, Tursik, one of these little arrogant, strutting guys when he runs up on the podium. And he was the managing director at Goldman Sachs, where he played a key role, this is from his bio, in developing the firm's environmental strategy. Goldman Sachs is the number one funder of carbon taxes and land grabs. Well, of course they are. Ken Lay of Enron came up with this operation. And what they do through General Electric is they get a waiver for their coal power plants, but they shut everybody else down. So that clip's coming up. And he agreed to the interview. Our guys are taping. And then when they ask the question about Obama wanting to bankrupt coal, he freaks out and runs off. And then says, turn the camera off. So my guy kind of instinctively turns it off and then turns it back on. And McBreen chases him down the hall, saying, but what about General Electric getting waivers? And it was like... he was a vampire that had been shown a giant silver cross. It was like, ah! I mean, he jumped out of his skin. Or it was like roaches when you flip the light on. This big giant one looking at you. Oh, God. I mean, do you know how much money insiders are going to make by shutting down most of the coal power plants but their own when it provides 51%+ of our power in this country? And are so clean now, all that comes out is carbon dioxide. That's why they list it as a pollutant now. But I digress. Let's go to clip one. Eco Monsanto. Perspectives on Monsanto Corp. We actually got a little more intelligent answers on this subject. One lady thinks, oh, they're doing a lot better these days. This is a group, and all these major GMO crops have been found to cause infertility, all these problems connected to honeybees dying. You know, the first clip's a lady who just thinks, you know, that Monsanto is very loving. The next lady's a professor who is probably the smartest person at the whole conference. She's the equivalent of a third grader to this show, but she understood some of the basic problems. We might get her on and school her, and then we'll get into some of the other clips. Here it is.
What do you think about Monsanto Corporation?
Interesting question. I knew you would ask.
Is that the bad word? Is that the bad word?
No, you know, it's, I mean, I think everyone has their opinion on Monsanto and the big agribusiness companies, and certainly they're far from perfect, but I think Monsanto has really been making a real effort to listen to their critics and improve their practices.
When it comes to a Monsanto, they own 90% of the genetically modified seed market, and they take very seriously the proprietary nature of the work that they've done and the investment they've made. So farmers who purchase and use Monsanto's seeds are required to sign contracts to ensure that they will not be saving their seeds and they will not be cleaning them or sharing them or using them for another season.
Should Monsanto be able to... trademark seeds, and then you can't get original seeds to grow corn, and you have that's the whole direction of that industry is under kind of corporate control and things like that. You've come a long way from the farmer planting his corn seeds.
This relatively new system, which has really only been in place for a handful of decades, asserts that seeds are no longer a commons. They are no longer in the hands of farmers, but rather they belong to corporations.
Here's why I think people have a problem with Monsanto is because the local farming industry seems to be being shut down, but almost forcibly. I know you've heard the horror stories where they go in like mafia style, and with their lawyers and everything, and shut down farms who might have had a seed that blew into their farm and that sort of thing. And then these farmers can't afford the high-priced lawyers. They get shut down. But also... that a lot of local farming communities, like people are being arrested in California for selling milk. Have you heard of stuff like that, and what are your thoughts of that?
I have heard of stuff like that, and I absolutely agree that those practices are problematic and shouldn't be followed.
My concern is that whoever controls the seeds controls the food supply, and what we're doing is seeing a concentration of that control into very few hands, and into those hands are hands of corporations.
I mean, I think Monsanto's practices should be corrected. I think that some of the things they've done are problematic.
To me, there's a real problem in the patenting of life, especially life that we depend on to continue living. I understand that a lot of research and development money was poured into the creation of certain kinds of seeds, but I believe that there's an intrinsic challenge in asking people to sign contracts not to share and save their seeds, and into patenting technology that that really is required to sustain life. So to me, the fact that life forms are now in corporate hands rather than a trust of the people or in the hands of the government as something, as a representative of the people, is incredibly problematic.
Now I'm going to go to Mark Tursik, who runs up gingerly to the podium and, "Hi, I'm from Goldman Sachs. I'm the head of Nature Conservancy. We're going to shut down all our competition's power plants," but that's not really what he said. And then he was standing there with a long line of minions to interview him. You can't see it in the shot, but my crew told me about it. And our guys get up there first. He agrees to the interview, and they say, "Well, yeah, what about Obama saying he wants to bankrupt coal power plants?" And it is just like deer in the headlights. Whoa, I'm not doing this. I'm not doing this. It's just incredible. And then McBrain chased him down the hall and tried to bring up, "Well, General Electric, they're exempt from this, and they're on the president's council." And, of course, they talked to folks earlier about, "Well, China gets to build these, but we don't." Well, that's problematic, but so what? As long as America's destroyed, I mean, as long as we run everything. Listen, we decide your light bulb, your toilet, everything. And GMO's not too bad, though. Sure, it sterilizes the little mice, but there's too many of those as well, too many people. We're trendy. We're going to talk to you like this. And in fact, let me just get into before I go to this guy. I'm a Goldman Sachs. We're the folks that brought you derivatives. You know, we work with Ken Lay on this carbon tax thing. How you doing, Buffy? Oh my God, Gilligan, what are we going to do with you? The people are waking up." And after he was done running, he was like, "Run away, stop." You like the emperor or something in that joke piece they do. But he's scurrying away like a miscreant rodent. And, he didn't like saying, "You don't have my authorization to use this." The camera was off by them, but they told me about it. "You're at a public event. Our media came in. You're a public figure, pal, trying to shut down our power plants. We will show you, and I hope you sue me, because I want to countersue you, and I want to get into those minutes. I want to get into those minutes. I want to get into that discovery process with you so bad. You just think you sit there and trendy. You can't take me. And we're just going to urinate on ourselves and go, yes, master, you're a trendy East Coaster. You're liberal. You're too powerful." Let's go ahead and go to the clip. Here it is.
"He helped pioneer groundbreaking new land preservation techniques such as conservation easements and debt for nature swaps, and works with all sectors of society, including businesses, individuals, communities, and government agencies. His initiatives are vast and challenging, his approaches varied and creative, and with over 1 million members strong, his reach undeniable."
We are getting all the property. I am a control freak pinhead. I am trendy. Oh, look at this guy. Now watch how he struts up on the stage. Oh, they cut it.
"Let me just say it's a real honor to be here at the first South by Southwest Eco Forum.
Hi, I'm Goldman Sachs. I want to pray upon you.
For a long time, I worked at Goldman Sachs. I know it's not very fashionable to praise.
Oh, but you're trendy, though.
Especially Goldman Sachs these days, but thank you for not booing.
We're waging war on the real economy.
I had a really good career there, but in my career, I got very interested in business. I worked with lots of big businesses, and I'm one of these true believers who thinks business can really make a positive difference.
We're with InfoWars Nightly News and KLBJ.
All right.
In Austin, Texas.
Okay, good. Let's start. What's your questions?
Well,
that one's too complicated for
me. Here, let me hold the mic just so I can get my question in there anyway. But These are more of the for the proponents, I guess, if you will, of coal power plants. I'm just trying to get both sides of the story. But I want to know if you're familiar with President Obama's statement that he wanted to bankrupt the coal fire plants.
I don't think I want to do this, all right? I'm going to pass. Thanks.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm not ready on this topic, and I don't really like video because...
I got one that can see. We should have that clip where I got one that can see. Get in there and deal with them right now. He was looking at you with that predatory scanning, zzz, control, zzz, manipulate scientific data, zzz, take over, blast, control, world government, zzz, shut down infrastructure, zzz, ship everything to China. Zzz, zzz. He's just, zzz, look at this person. And you're like, I can see. And he's like, whoa, 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 no, a red alert, red alert. Ah, ah, humanity will crush you. I love it. They're weak. And the minute we reveal them, their destruction begins. Ah. What about what? Roll the coal clip. Go ahead.
I don't know if you're familiar with President Obama's statement that he wanted to bankrupt the coal power industry.
Well, that's not a fair statement. I hope he didn't make that statement.
So if somebody wants to build a coal power plant, they can. It's just that it will bankrupt them because they're going to be charged a huge sum for all that greenhouse gas that's being emitted.
That's not the way to fix things by any means. You know, coal is a asset that we have, and, you know, if we can burn it clean, that'd be great.
Well, I think that coal is, like, I think that's the largest emitter of carbon as far as our energy sources go, and I think that's a good idea to shut them down.
But the thing is they're shutting down and they're moving to China, so how is it better for the Earth in China than it is in the U.S.?
Definitely not. I think that in China they're trying to build industry, and I see that as a good thing. However, I don't think coal is necessary.
Hit pause right there.
To build.
I shot that video along with Rob Jacobson, who's out there back from vacation. Just joking, Rob. I shot that video. I shot that video out the window with Rob, and it was like below zero in Billings, Montana. And all that is hot air coming out and carbon dioxide and water vapor. But they'll show it and go, look at the smoke. It's deadly. The nothing comes out of those. There's giant scrubbers. And that's what supplies your power. And Austin Energy's admitting it's going to be like a 60% increase in the next few years just off the eco stuff. Nothing to do with the environment.
People are like, I think it's good old ladies are going bankrupt on the Social Security. If we pay the big oil companies that are shutting down coal more money, it'll fix it.
And look, I just get mad at these Goldman Sachs guys and these scammers. And it's just good to realize what scum they are and how afraid they are and that we see who they are. It's victory. The minute you uncloak them, the minute you just see them for what they are like worms. They are so weak. I'm sorry, I have a little celebration there. And when I do get that insane, I do start like tasting metal in my mouth and stuff. I can literally feel them evaporating underneath my feet. And we will defeat them. Oh, we will go to the Fed tomorrow as well and occupy it. Okay. Socialism. Yeah, those that doubt that the big banks are trying to fund socialism instead of getting rid of the Federal Reserve, this is... This is out of Pittsburgh. It's an email. Occupy Pittsburgh, cooped or co-opt by the socialists. And this is being handed out. And he says, hey, guys, I just wanted to share this little gem of magazine being touted at the General Assembly. There were 400 people there. And then the article continues, the email. And he goes on to say that I hopped on the mic and proposed a monetary policy working group, since you know it's the actual problem, and it was overwhelmingly nayed. Yeah, they just want to take money from somebody that's got money. And of course, they got angry and booed them off the stage, except for a few info warriors. Okay, so there you have it. We got to go ahead and get to the interview coming up here in a moment. We even have more, though. We have Luke Radowski being manhandled by our loving New York police that were given $4.6 million the day before.